Hi, welcome to Barney Tech Channel. In this section, we are going to see about the reason for loss of field and its operating area. First, we will see the reason for loss of field. When accidentally exciter CB get opened during generator running condition, then the rotor field loss its power supply and the system will undergo under excitation. Next, if the exciter power supply get open circuit, then also the rotor undergoes under excitation. Then if the exciter system get short circuit fault, even heavy rotor earth fault, also the system will undergo under excitation. Even if the voltage regulation get problem, then also the system may get under excitation problem. This all the reason we have seen for loss of field. Now we will see what are the way to find the loss of field while under excitation occurs on generator. First, it is very easy method to detect the loss of field is to check the field current. That is, if the magnetic field produced on the rotor due to exciter, then definitely there will be a current flow on it. On other case, if there is no current flow, we can understand that there is a problem on rotor, but this is less accuracy on current setting value. Second method is by measuring reactive power of the generator. We can able to detect the loss of field production. Since this normal running condition, the VAR is exported from the generator, but mainly during under excitation problem, the VAR is imported from the grid to generator. By using this also, we can able to detect loss of field, but sometime this method get mal operate. The third one is by using impedance method. In that, we have a special one, offset mo. This is one of the successful method to detect the loss of field. And also it avoid more mal operation, such as for power swing fault, system fault, such as heavy short circuit and earth fault, etc. And also stable transient condition. In this offset mo, we will see little deeper. We all know the mo characteristics, but what is mean by offset mo? The name offset mean just below or above zero axis. Next, we have a doubt why we go for offset mo. And for offset mo, we have name XD dash by 2. And the dia of the mo is XD. Now we will see the generator. In generator, we have stator and rotor. When the rotor rotate with magnetic field, the stator also produce one magnetic field, which also go along with rotor magnetic field with some angle. Let us consider it is a alpha. During this time, the generator has a reactance, its XD. Then what is XD dash? It is the transient stage. Before going to this transient stage, we will see one small demo video. In this, the ball is attached with thread and moves slowly from one place to other place. During this time, the ball get less oscillation. But if the same ball is traveling same distance but faster than previous one, now you can notice the ball get oscillate very much. After some time, this oscillation will come to steady state. Same way on generator, we'll have the maximum torque limit. If we add gradually, then the magnetic rotating angle between stator and rotor will be constant. Let us consider the load connected to generator is 30%, and suddenly if we add 20% of load to generator, the same like ball, the generator also loses the steady state and the angle of alpha started to vary. After some time, this oscillation come to steady state. In this case, we will not face much problem if we add less load suddenly. On other case, if the generator is more than 50% of load and we are connecting heavy load suddenly to generator, in this case, the oscillation will be very high. So during this oscillation, the first stage is named as XD double dash and the second stage of oscillation is named as XD dash. Then it will reaches the steady state. If we see offset diagram, during this oscillation, the generator will reach nearer to the offset area. Actually, this heavy load case is not related with loss of field. But during this oscillation, the generator reaches this area. So the more characteristics is below the zero crossing. In order to avoid the mall operation on such heavy load, it may be a heavy short circuit fault also. On other case, if the real loss of field occurs, then the generator directly will fall on to this operating region and it will be stay within this region. Now we came to the end. On next section, I am planning to make how to test the loss of field protection. We came to the end of this section. See you on next video. If you like this section, then please share to your friends and colleagues. Take care and bye from Barney Tech channel. Thank you for watching this video.